All right, good morning, everyone. Well, we've been watching the weather forecast. We almost pulled it off, but at least it's not snowing. And it does sound like the weather's going to cooperate for Employee Appreciation Day, so please make sure you stop and see the vendors later in between, and then get something to eat starting at 11. On behalf of the Board of County Commissioners, the Administrative Judge, the State's Attorney, and the Sheriff, welcome to our 39th Annual Employee Recognition Program. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today, we're celebrating and recognizing the dedication and accomplishment of 45 employees who've provided a combined total of 615 years of service to Carroll County citizens. And you all look too young for that. I want to share with you a quote, but first, how many Ravens fans are out here? All right, so you're going to hate me for this quote because it's from Vince Lombardi. Sorry, I'm a Packers fan. It's time for all of us to stand and cheer for the doer, the achiever, the one who recognizes the challenges and does something about it. Each of you are the achievers in the organization, meeting both everyday and extraordinary challenges while continuing to provide excellent service to the citizens of Carroll County. You should be proud of your contributions to the county and its citizens. Know that you represent the positive in Carroll and are appreciated for your dedication and service. And now I'd like to introduce the Honorable Judge Michael Galloway.
Good morning. We have a smaller crowd here than usual. I usually start off by making a point of thanking everybody who provides services to the court. I'm here to recognize some employees from the circuit court, but I never like to leave without recognizing other departments, agencies who provide assistance to the court. And of course, I think the people here today certainly fall into that category. Tough being a public employee today, money's tight. A lot of extra challenges. I read the article with interest the other day about some of the challenges that certain people are facing in order to do the job because of the fact they really don't have enough people to get the job done, which is somewhat discouraging. But I would say this. The people here today, based upon my contact, and of course I have regular contact with the Sheriff's Department, they provide on a daily basis service to us and assistance to us, which is essential and is greatly appreciated. All the people here today, I heard 600 plus years of total service. Well, we have a couple of people here today who represent a big chunk of that 600 and, what was it, 615? Yes. Well, since we have to burn the flag now, there's another expense. Oh, no. Mr. Barnes, would you get up there and hold that? without further ado, I'd like to recognize the people who are here today from the circuit court. Joanne Kreider, 5 years of service. Come on up. Come on up. Joanne works in our family law office, and she really provides, you could come on up here, provides invaluable service. One of the biggest things she does is she mediates cases. Many times people come in on domestic violence cases, and they're many times in a state of emotion, anger, and what she does is sit down with the parties and see if they can reach an agreement. And she's very often successful in doing that, and because of that, saves the court a great deal of time, and we appreciate her invaluable service. Lisa Collier. Lisa's been with the county for 10 years. She's been with the circuit court. How long now, Lisa?
A year in July.
And she is the assistant to our jury commissioner. We've gotten to the point now where it really got to be unrealistic to think that one person could handle all the work associated with our jury trial system. And Lisa's done a great job since she's been with us. Rebecca Eckert. Rebecca is the judicial assistant to Judge Barry Hughes. She's been with us for 10 years, which is hard for me to believe. Hard for me to believe that Judge Hughes has been with us for 10 years. He came in 2004, and he brought Rebecca with him, and I get to see Rebecca in action every day because physically our offices are located very close to each other. She really hit the ground running with this job, and I know Judge Hughes thinks that she does an exceptional job working with him. Bobby Erb. Bobby is being recognized today for 35 years of service. That's one of the strengths of the circuit court is we have employees, many employees, who stay for a long time. And Bobby is our court administrator. She's the only court administrator that the circuit court has ever had. She assumed that position many years ago, and on a day-to-day basis, she is responsible for making sure that things run smoothly. I couldn't begin to tell you all the things that she does. One of the big things that she does is she's a liaison between the circuit court and the administrative office of the courts in Annapolis. She keeps threatening to retire. I keep trying to talk her out of it, at least until I retire, which is not too far down the road. Flossie J. Barnes. Flossie probably wears more different hats than just about anybody I can think of. She's our court librarian. She assists with our jury commissioner. Prior to Lisa coming on board, Flossie very often was called into service to work with our juries, and she's done a tremendous job over the years. We're very lucky to have somebody who's been willing to take on different responsibilities and do it in a very conscientious, responsible way. So over here, we have 70 years of service, very dedicated, loyal people. All of our people have done an exceptional job. That's why it's my pleasure today to recognize all of these individuals. Without them, we wouldn't be able to do nearly as effective a job, and I wouldn't look nearly as good as I do. On a daily basis, what they do is make myself and the other judges look good. And I appreciate that. I don't mean physically. There's nothing can be done about that. But in terms of the way the court runs, they really are invaluable to us, and we appreciate everything they do. I hope all of you have a great day. I hope that you know that I appreciate everything you do. And with that, we're going to be on our way.
All right, I did forget that part of the instruction. Once you're called up and congratulated and your elected official is done, then you can go down here and get your certificates for today, okay? Next is Mr. Jerry Barnes, our state's attorney.
All right, I don't look too bad physically because I lost 70 pounds. Deliberately. And I'm not going to echo what Judge Galloway said because I don't think it's necessary at this point. But we have 80 years of service here present. They're all not here because one's off, another's getting ready for a jury trial. And so we don't have everybody here, but I think we do have 50 years of experience here, and I'm gonna call you up one at a time. First of all, we have William J. Mathias, who everybody calls, and he's known by Mr. Bill. And Mr. Bill, his job is to provide discovery, that is to provide all the police reports, all the evidence, all the witness lists, and everything else we have, and coordinate witnesses in preparation for jury trials for circuit court. And he also volunteers for, I don't know how many hours, 20 hours a week at the hospital?
No, it's just 4 hours on Friday afternoon.
Oh, he volunteers his time at the hospital also. So he's been here a long time. And before that, tell him how many years you worked for the circuit court.
26 years.
And he worked in the clerk's office when Bob Bear and a bunch of older gentlemen were there. Yeah. And when I first started, I remember him over there. So just stand there and relax. Right. Okay. Michelle Schaefer is our victim witness director, and she's also a certified mediator. And she mediates a lot of cases. She helps the police out a lot because constantly they're getting called to certain locations for what are basically ridiculous neighborhood disputes. And a lot of times we're able to bring these people into the office, sit both parties down at a table, and resolve their differences without going through the court system or without continuing to bother the police for situations that they have no need to be involved in. They're out there to catch criminals and to solve crime, not to solve neighborhood disputes. So she's not here today because she had another commitment, but she also has 10 years of service. Now next is Tamara Boyd. You can come up too. And Tamara is here for 15 years of service, and she works in our district court section as in the support staff in various modes, but our district court section is the busiest section we have. They're handling now currently roughly in excess of over 5,000 new cases a year, 5,000. And it's a very difficult job. And we're also shorthanded. But like Judge Galloway said, there's no money. But wanted to thank you for your service. Glad you're here. You look very nice this morning.
Thank you.
I know the ladies like that. My wife's gone. I think. Anyhow, the next person I have was Melissa Hawkinsmith. Now, she's not here because she is currently, and she's been all week, preparing for a pretty complicated economic crime trial that I believe starts tomorrow. She would have 20 years of service. And we have a white-collar crime unit, economic crime unit. Andy Mays is their investigator, and he's with her this morning. And over the years, I can tell you this, they're one of the busiest units in the office today, and they have recovered millions and millions of dollars for business people, doctors, dentists, and any kind of other kind of business enterprise that you could think of. And they're incredibly busy. We have one left who is here, and she has longest tenure of anybody standing up here, and that's Ann Patterson. Come on up, Ann. Thank you, Ann. And Ann works in our child support division, which has recently been, since last summer, been moved to the Sherwood Distillery Building on the second floor. And our child support division monitors over 3,000 cases every year. They establish child support orders. They conduct contempt hearings when people don't pay their child support. And they also conduct paternity hearings to determine who, if anyone, is the father of a child. And this year, they're working their way toward collecting $10 million. $10 million. And they work with the Department of Social Services with their Bureau of Support Enforcement. And we've always maintained that unit. There are 11 people in that unit total. Two attorneys, one of the investigators is also an attorney and will soon be an accountant. So actually we have three attorneys in that unit, although he gets paid as only being an investigator. But he'll soon be a CPA and he's also an attorney. So that concludes my remarks. I want to thank you all, and you have to check in over here, and they will tell you how you can get all your rewards for all this time. Okay. Okay, and while I'm up here, I want to, this gentleman standing, sitting here by the flag, he's guarding the flag. You know, I can't tell you how helpful he has been to me and to members of my office. Since he has been with the county, and he's been there a long, long time. And he's been there through a lot of boards of commissioners, and so have I. And I give him all the credit in the world. And I wish him the best of luck in his new endeavors. And I just want to thank you, Steve.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm finished. Anybody got any questions for their state's attorneys? I'm so used to standing up in front of crowds like this now. Anybody got any questions? Raise your hand. Good. You're next.
I am next again. All right. And now I would like to present Sheriff Ken Tredegoni.
Feel like I'm preaching to the choir. Before I start, I don't have any startling decorations or any long-winded speech either, because you all are cold, and I'm all about creature comfort. But I would be remiss if I didn't take the opportunity to publicly thank Steve Powell for his 29 years of service to the county. It was always my belief in working with him for about 16 years that he was not only the heart and soul of county government, but probably the brains too. And I hope too many politicians didn't hear that, or maybe they should. Congratulations on your new job. The county will sorely miss you, as will I. And we wish you the best. Let's have a round of applause for Steve, please. Major Strine, front and center. Captain Hart, I can use your help too. I do like to get our employees involved when it comes to presentations. They work with them on a daily basis, see them on a daily basis, and certainly interact on a daily basis, more so than I do. And they are in positions of leadership, and I expect them to rise in higher positions in the future. So they should take this opportunity to publicly thank you for what you do. Okay? Denny?
Can we go through my list?
Yeah.
All right, on behalf of the detention center, I'd like to call the deputies or correctional officers that are not here. Eric Meck, 5 years of service. Rex Scott Jr., 5 years of service. Brendan Stevens, 5 years of service. Robert Smith, 5 years of service. Jeffrey Ackerman, 10 years of service. Robert Stronsky, 10 years of service. Nicholas Zafiris, 10 years of service. Paula Hyde, 15 years of service. Ken Chesgreen, 20 years of service. And Virginia S. Miller, 25 years of service. Those correctional officers and administrative employees that are here, Jack Medeiros, if you would come up, 5 years of service, and is also our Correctional Officer of the Year this year. Robin Shorb, 5 years of service. Eileen Cummings, 15 years of service. Melissa Price, 15 years of service. And finally, Captain Steve Miller, 25 years of service. I want to thank all these men and women. What they do day in and day out is unbelievable. It is why we are not in the newspaper on a daily basis. It's because we have a safe staff, experienced staff, and I'm proud of all of them. Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Captain Richard Hart. I'm the commander of the Criminal Investigations Division within the Sheriff's Office. I want to start off real quick with our employees that have other commitments. Are we doing that? Okay.
No, we
got
the
it. We're good.
List of people are here.
Okay. The list of people that are here right now would be, at 10 years of service, is Corporal Gunnar Burke. Could you step up, please? He is currently one of our patrol supervisors. Does a great job every day. He's out there keeping us safe, keeping a squad in line. 10 years of service. 10 years of service, Christine Garvin. She was for the longest time the administrative assistant at the Criminal Investigations Division. She has just recently accepted a job as our new crime analysis person. It's a brand new position within the Sheriff's Office that's going to be able to correlate our crime stats. So we're looking forward to her continuing a great job that she does every day. Moving on. 15 years of service. Sheriff Dragoni, please step up.
I'm good.
Please step up,
just
sir.
Just go right ahead.
Okay. Okay. Thank you again, sir, for your service. Not with us today after 25 years of service, Master Deputy Worthy Washington. He is our DARE officer. He's been a DARE officer since I've been here. He does a phenomenal job. The schools love him. The children love him. He's a great employee. And 30 years of service, Mr. Doug Abbott. Great job. He is our fiscal coordinator. Every year he gets our money together. He makes sure that I get my money for my dry cleaning and I get new boots every year. We appreciate what you do. Again, 15 years of service, Roxanne Yeager. She's the administrative assistant in the patrol division. She makes sure that the reports are done properly and our FOIA requests are done properly. And without a doubt, she's always available for us when we need her. And I don't think I skipped anybody. I think we're good.
You all done?
I think we're all done, sir.
Okay. I want to mention the people that are not here, and these obviously can't attend because of their job duties. It's correctional officers, or I'm sorry, court security officers. It's Boone and Lyons, Magnolio, and Shu are not here because they are attending to the courts. For 10 years of service, who are not here, we have Miss Linda Lyons. She is busy this morning with other work. Corporal Jeffrey Miller, Lieutenant David Stem. They have 10 years of service. And for 15 years of service, we have Corporal Fritz. I'm assuming he is on patrol, and Court Security Officer John Thomas. 20 years of service. We have Doug Carr, who is also attending to the court, and for 25 years of service, I think you mentioned Mrs. Miller, right?
Yeah.
I'd like to also recognize an individual in the audience today. She is an intern for us. Katie, would you come up here, please? It's an exciting time for Katie. She's a senior at Manchester Valley, a Maverick. She also plays basketball and a field hockey player. They are currently in the finals for the state or the region. What is it? The region?
Regional finals tonight.
Regional finals. They play Walkersville Lions tonight, and we wish her the best. We thank you for your hard work with us. We hope you've learned something, and perhaps a career in law enforcement might be in your future down the road. I want to thank Amanda Hart for attending to Katie and to showing her the ropes, and hopefully sending you on your way to, you're going to college, right? Where at?
Notre Dame, Maryland.
All right, Notre Dame, down there on Charles Street.
Yes, sir.
We wish you the best, Katie, and thank you.
Thank you.
And thank everyone else. Thank you.
Welcome, everyone, to our 39th Annual Employee Recognition Program. It's my pleasure to be here for my final ceremony. And it's a very difficult but heartwarming event for me. I have loved and still love coming to work for Carroll County Government. I have grown up in Carroll County Government, both physically and professionally, personally and professionally. I met my bride while I was here in government. And for those of you who worked for me prior to being married, I hear I was not very understanding or sympathetic to outside commitments. Then I had children, and then I became even more embarrassed about the requirements I had placed on folks. But we are here today to celebrate folks' tenure with Carroll County Government, some incredible tenures. And so I welcome all of you. I'd like to introduce the president of our Board of County Commissioners, Mr. David Rausch. He will be here to congratulate you and to thank you for your years of service as you're called up and recognized. I would like to begin, if we would all rise, for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now I must take a short detour from the agenda here. Some of us in the audience, as I look out, have gone past the age of 50. Some are looking at arriving at the age of 50, and there is at least one here today who is turning 50. And Rose, would you... I won't make you stand, but I would ask for all of us, and I'll step away from the mic because you really don't want my voice in the mic, but I'd like to sing Happy Birthday to Rose. And for any of us who've had a retreat or had opportunity to go to Ashwa, we know what a great job she does.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
And Rose, I can honestly say it only gets better. Every year just seems to bring new things into life, and it only gets better. Little creaks, that kind of stuff, but life generally gets better. I'm going to ask Kim to come up, and you'll see Kim and I switching because at the earlier ceremony with the courts, the sheriff, and the state's attorney, the wind picked up and the flag went down. So we'll keep our toe on the flag. Kim?
Good morning, everybody. All right, I have a message from Commissioner Frazier. She's asked me to read.
She regrets not being able to attend the awards this morning. She's attending the We're On Our Way Partnership Awards event, but is looking forward to greeting folks in the luncheon line today. So I wanted to pass that along from Commissioner Frazier. All right. Our office started watching the forecast last Monday. Over the weekend, there was some crying in my house because every other day it was 70% chance of rain, 20, 70. But we're pulling it off. It's getting better. And there is one good thing about the weather forecast today. There is no snow in it. And we really hope you all have an enjoyable recognition program as well as employee appreciation. We've got lots of games, vendors, and great food. So make sure you all visit all the vendors and stay and have a good time. So on behalf of the county commissioners, again, welcome to our 39th annual program. We're celebrating 85 employees today with 1,310 years of service. It's a lot of service. And I want to share a quote today, but first I need to know, how many Ravens fans? All right, none of you are going to like me, so you might not want to listen. Because a lot of you know I'm a Green Bay fan. Sorry. So the quote I have is from Mr. Lombardi. It's time for all of us to stand and cheer for the doer, the achiever, the one who recognizes the challenges and does something about it. Each of you here today, as well as your colleagues that will be here later for the other event, are the achievers in this organization, meeting both everyday and extraordinary challenges while continuing to provide excellent service to the citizens of Carroll County. You should be proud of your contributions to the county and its citizens, and know that you represent the positive in Carroll and are appreciated for your dedication and service. After a few reminders for the program today, once your name is called and you come up to be recognized, then we would ask you to go over to the tent where Julie's at to receive your award. And then we'd like you to come back and hang out for everybody else to be recognized as well. We're going to shift it up a little bit this year. We're going to call out of order. We're doing this by department, but we're calling some folks out of order. So I would like to ask Rob Burke, Tom Rio. Is Tom here? No. Jeff, I'll take you if Tom's not here. That wasn't meant to be that way. Sorry. That didn't sound good, did it? Sorry. And Mr. Phil Hager. And the reason I'm having these folks come up is they're the supervisors of the folks that have been here the longest time today. Unfortunately, our 40-year folks aren't here, but Mr. Alfie Wetzel and Mr. Mike Whitson are joining our 40-year club. They've been here for 40 years. Not quite sure how old they were when they started, but for 35 years of service, Mr. Joe Carnaggio. And Ms. Shawn Reese also had 35 years of service, but she's unable to be with us today. For 30 years of service, Mr. Clay Black. Ms. Meg Herring. Ms. Karen Monroe. And my favorite, who always teases me about the Green Bay Packers, Mr. Negley. And then I am going to invite one other person up just so I can shake his hand as well. Mr. Steve Powell, you're not getting an award this year, but thank you very much for everything you've done for the county, and we are going to miss you. And now Steve is going to start with his awards.
When the folks who just received the long tenured awards come back, or when you're back in the office, ask Joe about Carmack. If any of you longer tenured folks, my first year here was the last year of the grand Christmas parties for Carroll County, in which there were conga lines going through the building, and food and beverage of your choice nearly every office. And we used to have an annual event in which Joe and another perpetrator would do a skit or a play, which typically mocked out everybody in the county. And it was a lot of fun and led to a great sense of camaraderie. I don't even think we could legally do some of the things we've done way back then, but it certainly lent to an air of festivities during those times. It was a hoot. As I'm going to speak to folks broadly at the director level and appointeds in our county. Sean Reese has been here for 35 years. She was a secretary in the commissioner's office. She worked for aging and Department of Rec and Parks and then came back as our clerk. And Sean is had a very difficult year and is unable to be with us today, but please continue to think of her. She has served us well. I'd like to invite two folks to come up and then I'll speak a few moments. I'd like Mr. Mark Ripper and Mr. Rob Burke. Mark has been here for 25 years. Thank you very much. He came many years ago, I recall it well. Mr. Tom Vandenbosch was the director back then. And he was one of our first of two PC folks. And that's when we had double floppy disks. And that was living large. Look at what we have today. Everything that sat on my desk and under my desk sits in the palm of my hand. And for those who are more adept, it probably does a heck of a lot more than I do with it. But thank you, Mark, for 25 years of service. Mr. Rob Burke, our comptroller, came 15 years ago under Mr. Gene Kerfman. And just demonstrated his commitment and his financial acumen to everyone. It was my pleasure under a prior board to ask Rob to join us as the comptroller. And we continue to march forward. We have, in conjunction with other members of the financial team, with budget and Rob, we have two AAAs and a AA+. That's remarkable for our jurisdiction, our size, and with our economic base. And I thank you for your financial leadership over the years. And I think they have some gift for you across the way. So thank you very much.
For Human Resources, I'd like to recognize Ms. Susan Kiker for 15 years of service. And this is also going to be Susan's last employee appreciation because she will be leaving us on June 4th for retirement. So we congratulate her. Next, I'd like to have Mr. Mark Ripper come back up. Oh, he's over there.
Is he aware?
No. Mark, it's your turn. Your turn.
Good morning again. Today I have four people in my department that I'm recognizing for their years of service. Some of you may know them, but a lot of you probably do not. The first person is Susan Scoville. She's been with our department for 10 years, and for most of that time she has been down in the computer room hiding in the evenings, making sure all the backups got done and everything was taken care of. She was recently promoted to being one of our repair techs, so she has been getting out and about a little bit more. So hopefully you've seen her. So Susan, if you could come on up. I have two people with 15 years of service. Most of you probably know one of these employees. She's been around, actually started, this was the person who started with me in the IT department. She left county government for a little while and moved to Delaware, but she's come back, and that's Patricia Cross. She's not able to be here today. And then the other is Diana Fisher, one of the client service analysts. Both of them have been here for 15 years. My final and longest term employee here today is Mr. Kevin Shorb. I know that the Human Resources Department is extremely familiar with Kevin. He is the programmer for all of their applications. And again, the programmers unfortunately don't get to get out around the county a whole lot. They're downstairs, they meet with the people they need to meet with, but they are playing a very important role, okay? Kevin is responsible for the fact that you do get a paycheck every 2 weeks, okay? So Kevin, if you could come on up, please.
I can have Mr. Scott Campbell.
Good morning. We Office of Public Safety Support Services, and we have four employees you recognize today, all of which are employees of the 911 center. And unfortunately, as is often the case, because of their unique schedule, none are able to attend today. But I still want to recognize them, and I'll say it now instead of at the end. In the past, when we've had people recognized for these milestones in their career, I've asked that when you see them wherever, at the grocery store, at your church, wherever, please thank them, because they are the women and men who 24/7 staff the 911 center. And if you ever need them, they are the first folks that you're going to make contact with when something bad happens, a medical emergency, a car accident, et cetera. So they are truly the very leading edge of the emergency services or first responder community. So I know you appreciate that, but I encourage you when you have the chance, just please express that appreciation to them. 5 years of service. Corey Wetzel, Rodney Valentine, who I have to share is retiring, Randy, in a couple of months. And Charlie Barnhart. I think a lot of you know Charlie. And Charlie was actually planning to join us today. Those of you who know Charlie knows he is very involved in his church, and he's actually conducting a funeral service this morning, and that's why he had to cancel at the last minute. But I'm also very, actually was a little surprised. I didn't realize that Jack had the number of years that he has with us, but Jack Brown, who's the assistant coordinator of the 911 center, is actually celebrating 20 years with the county. And Jack, too, came to the county, I believe, initially as a dispatcher, shift supervisor, and he's worked himself up to where he's now second in charge of the 911 center. So, again, if you would, folks, when you see these, wherever it is, on the job, on a Saturday, please express your thanks to them. They are most deserving. Thank you.
Mr. Jeff Daggett.
Good morning. We have three individuals to be recognized this morning. All three work at the Hoshua Environmental Center. Many of you are familiar with that facility. You know it because of outdoor school. What some of you may not know is that facility is rented over 350 days out of the year. Because of that, there's a whole lot of maintenance that needs to occur at that facility, and there's a whole lot of meals that are served both on-site and off-site at different meetings. We are fortunate to have an incredibly dedicated staff there, and we have a couple of them here today that I'd like to recognize. With 5 years of service, we have Mr. William George Stulkovich. With 10 years of service, and I don't know if Steve's here today, I haven't seen him yet, Stephen Abert. Steve is here, right up front. And with 20 years of service, and I have to put a little star next to this because I think she must have started when she was about 15, Rosemary Swartz, our birthday girl. Thank you very much.
It wasn't that bad, was it?
Thanks. Miss Madeline Moray.
Good morning. I'm coming to the closure of my first year as the Director of Citizen Services, and it's been a great pleasure to work with some of the finest staff that I've ever worked with in my career. Abraham Lincoln said, "Strive to be worthy of recognition," and I think that my staff live that every single day, and I would like to recognize some of them for that. For 10 years of service, we have Ms. Barbara Bingham. We also have Kathy Graff, but she was unable to attend. She had some commitments today at her job. And also Robin List is here. Thank you to both of you for 10 years of your service. Moving on to 15 years of service, both Renee Dieko and Kelly Gerard Weeks could not be here, but we do have with us Karen Larimore. And Ms. Mary Scholes. Is Mary with us? Okay. And also for 20 years, again, she must have started as a baby as well, Debbie Frame. Since I started with a bit of a quote, I would like to end with a quote too. Walt Disney said, "It is fun to do the impossible." And I think that my staff do the impossible, meeting the challenges of those with the greatest need and our most vulnerable population. So let's thank them again. Thank you, ladies.
Mr. Rob Burke. Everybody keeps running to the back of the room.
Just up here.
Thank you. Thank you to HR for hosting us today, and good morning. Up here a couple different times in different roles, but particularly pleased to represent the department and the years of service. I'm fortunate to have a department with many years of service in it. A lot of the staff has remained true to the county and served in the roles for a very long time. And the first I'd like to recognize with 15 years of service, Ms. Doreen Hazlip. Doreen's our Bureau Chief of Accounting and serves as the financial rock and solid foundation for everything we do, and I appreciate your service, Doreen. Got her beat by about 6 months, I think, when I joined the county. Heard a couple jokes today about people who might have started when they were 15 or 16 at the county. I'd like to introduce one that actually did, Becky Hellier, with 15 years of service. Becca joined us in the collections office during her high school years and worked her way through school and worked her way up into an accounting role, and we're glad to have you with us. Had two with 15 years of service unable to be here today, but would like to recognize from our purchasing office, Mary Moser, and from our collections office, Sandy Yingling. Both of those couldn't be here today, but had 15 years of service, if we can recognize them. Thank you. Move on to 20 years of service. Another part of the team that was mentioned earlier that makes sure that we all get that paycheck every 2 weeks. And since today's payday, I know she's particularly appreciated, Ms. Cheryl Hall, our payroll manager. Thank you, sir. And just that's all that we're able to join us today. I want to briefly mention three additional employees. Mr. Mike Enzer, with 25 years of service, serves as an accounting supervisor in the accounting office, but couldn't join us today, and already recognized, but certainly want to say my appreciation for 30 years of service to Meg Herring, and to with 35 years of service, Joe Carnaggio. Joe and Meg work together in keeping our office straight and have a lot of knowledge and work really well together. And for 30 and 35 years of service to the county, we appreciate your service. Thank you, and thank you.
Mr. John Wheatman.
Morning. It's my pleasure this morning to be able to recognize four important employees to the Department of Economic Development and recognize them for their service. Our department, like most departments, many of us wind up wearing a lot of hats and doing a lot of different things, and I have no better example of that than our recognition employee recognized for 10 years of service. Brian does just about everything from answering phones to setting up and tearing down events, organizing events, reserving rooms, runs our database management, pulls all the data that we need, and is also a very fine graphic designer on top of all of that, and helps on our marketing services. So I would like to welcome Brian Snyder to the stage and recognize him for 10 years of service. Thank you. Next, I get to recognize somebody for 15 years of service, and Susan has a little bit of home field advantage here. Working at the Farm Museum, and she's another fine example of the many county employees that work very hard behind the scenes so that when the citizens and visitors to Carroll County visit this wonderful facility, that they have an excellent experience. So I'd like to recognize Susan Dell for 15 years of service and thank her for what she does here at the Farm Museum. Speaking of behind-the-scenes service, it's my pleasure to recognize the third of four, and this is for 20 years of service. Georgia works very diligently and very hard at our Business Employment Resource Center over at Burke, and it is the folks, the employees we have exemplified by Georgia that do all that behind-the-scenes work that really allow the services that Burke delivers to not only our business community but the employment seekers within the county to receive the services and match those open jobs with the folks that want to fill them. So I'd like to thank Georgia Allen for 20 years of service and welcome her to the stage. Thank you. Okay. And last and certainly not least, also with 20 years of service, when I talk about a county employee that wears a lot of hats, if I were to go through the list of things that Denise does for us in the department, I would spill over into lunch, and I will not do that because that would not make me very popular. But as my right-hand woman and source of institutional knowledge within the department, a very necessary part of what we do, I'd like to thank Denise Beaver for 20 years of service and welcome her to the stage.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Mr. Phil Hager.
Good morning. I'd like to begin by thanking the Board of Commissioners for sponsoring this event. It's vitally important that we recognize the phenomenal contributions of all of our staff, and they are very supportive of the concept of doing just that. As I look around, it's also great to see so many faces of people who have retired who have come back for this event. So it's just a place I guess you just can't get out of, so I'm happy about that. I'd also like to thank our Human Resources Office for all the hard work that goes into planning this event and for the event that will follow today. Sun Tzu said that you're judged by the quality of your enemies. I'd like to add a corollary to that and say that I believe that we're judged by the people who will line up with you when you need to go to battle. And we don't necessarily go to battle every day, and that's certainly a good thing, but every day we're confronted with new challenges. And I'm happy to say that the people that are within my department and the people that I interact with in other departments every day seem to embrace that challenge. And that is what makes this place such a phenomenal environment in which to do business and in which to spend so much of your time. When you think about it, you probably spend more time here than anywhere else in your life, more time here than you do with your spouse, your children, or your families or friends. And that's vitally important that we have a great place to work, and I'm happy that we have that here. We have a number of people we're going to be recognizing today, and as I call your name, I'm going to ask that you come and join us here at the stage, and we'll wait until we have all of the people from all the different years of service, and then you can progress over to the tent area. First, with 5 years of service, Catherine Bolton. Catherine works in our Development Review Bureau. Jonathan Bowman. Jonathan works in our Bureau of Resource Management. Fred Jones. Is Fred here? There he is. Fred is also with our Bureau of Resource Management. Yes, I'm trying to emulate you, Fred. And Byron Madigan is not here today, but Byron also works in our Bureau of Resource Management. These are all of our employees from the 5-year service mark. Recognizing individuals with 10 years of service, Bonnie Bavard. Bonnie works in our Ag Preservation Program. Patty Schaefer. Patty works in our Bureau of Development Review. Robin Zile. Robin works in our zoning office. These individuals all have 10 years of service to the county. We have one individual with 15 years of service, Scott Graff. Scott works in our Bureau of Comprehensive Planning. With 20 years of service, Brenda Denny. Brenda is our Special Projects Coordinator. Rose Mann. Rose is one of our many valuable administrative staff members. We have one member with 25 years of service, Sandy Baber. Sandy is our GIS program manager, and we already recognized him, but we're going to ask him to come back up with 30 years of service, Clay Black. With deference to Scott Campbell, who said that his people are some of the first people that you meet when something bad happens. I'd like to add a little to that and say that these are the folks that you meet when something good happens. So thank you all for this opportunity, and join me in recognizing the staff of our department.
Mr. Ted Zaleski.
You know, Steve mentioned his premarital attitudes toward work and employees. I was one of those people. A time I remember well. Have just one employee in management and budget today. That's Chuck Paulson from our risk management area, 25 years. Chuck does a lot of important things to keep us out of trouble with MOSH and OSHA and meeting environmental laws. But maybe the most important thing that Chuck has done is introduce me to the summer food at the White Rock Church. If any of you don't know about it, ask Chuck. He'll be glad to talk with you about that at length. Thanks, Chuck.
Mr. Tom Rio and Mr. Jeff Topper.
This is always, I think, one of the most impressive days of the year. I'm grateful on a daily basis for the caliber of employee that the county manages to attract and maintain. And I'm always impressed by the number of years that our employees put in. To me, that never ceases to amaze me. So I'm glad that we have at least this one day when we can look at and see and appreciate each other for the years of service that we put in. And I'll say especially in public works, because I think public works is, for the most part, invisible to our citizens. We can be out there big as life doing what we do, but we're invisible unless we're not doing it. And then we're recognized right away. So we'll turn that around today and recognize folks for something that very much they should be recognized for. And I'll do this by Bureau. So starting with the Bureau of Engineering, 30 years of service, we've already recognized Karen Monroe. 25 years of service, Don Sperlin is not able to be here today, but he's put in 25 years of service here. 15 years of service, Adam Aldridge. And Steve Cornwell. And Gary Dye is unable to be here today. He's celebrating 5 years of service. Thank you, gentlemen. In the Bureau of Facilities, Mike Whitson was unable to be here today, celebrating 40 years. And Lynn Nagley has already been recognized for 30 years of service. 25 years of service, Dave Hardman is unable to be here, but he's celebrating 25 years, as is Doug Murin. And 10 years of service, Chuck Cross. Thank you. Going to Bureau of Fleet Management and Warehouse, 25 years of service is Rich Lamb, who is unable to be here today. 5 years of service is Brian Jones. In permits and inspections, Pat Cuffley is celebrating 20 years of service. Moving to roads operations, 25 years of service, Bill Kinna. Brian Tracy. 15 years of service. Joni Dunn is unable to attend today, but Lynn Carr is here. I think I saw Lynn. I didn't? Oh, I'm sorry, Larry Carr. My apologies. 10 years of service is Larry Fogle and Cliff Miller, who were unable to attend, and Garrett Reese. Celebrating 5 years of service, we have three folks that were unable to be here: Bill Hayes, Daniel Krug, and Eric Kopp. We do have two that are here: Gene King. And Charles Brightful. In solid waste, we have one person who is celebrating 40 years of service, Alfie Wetzel. He was recognized earlier, but unable to be here today. 15 years of service, Lisa Shriver. And 5 years of service, Maria Myers.
Congratulations.
For the Bureau of Utilities, for 15 years of service, Bill Hutchins was not able to be here today, but I think Karen Carr is.
Congratulations.
10 years of service, Joe Barrington is also unable to be here today. And 5 years of service, Richard Arbogast is unable to be here. But we do have 5 years, Sheena Hausman. Cody Romer. And Edward Schreer. And that does it for Public Works. Thank you.
And Commissioner Frazier has been able to join us, so I'd like to introduce Commissioner Frazier.
Thanks. I won't hold you up, but I did want to personally say thank you. I'm glad I caught the end, and I apologize for not being here in the beginning. Thank you all for your hard work, and I look forward to serving you a sandwich in the line. So I'll see you when you get there.
All right, as closing remarks, I just want to, again, thank everyone for all their dedicated service. You're a great bunch of people to work with, and we couldn't have a better workforce. So give yourself a round of applause. And one last final thank you for Steve. I know he doesn't want all this attention, but...
Heart is full. It has been an incredible part of my life. And because of all of you, whether our interactions were always good or not, you have made me who I am today. And I thank God for this experience. Thank you.